Hello students, in last lecture we studied about some examples based on a vector. Today we study third example. What is that? Find the position vector of a midpoint M joining the points L 7 minus 6 12 and N 5 4 minus 2. These are the coordinates of L and N. So firstly we have to find out the position vectors of L and N, and then after using midpoint formula we will find out the value of M, position vectors of M. Now what is the midpoint formula? Suppose there is a length AB or line AB or vector AB, and C divides AB, or C is a midpoint of AB, then C bar is equal to A bar plus B bar divided by 2. This is a midpoint formula. We use this midpoint formula in this example. For that, firstly, we find out the position vectors of point L and N. So, position vector of L is equal to 7i cap minus 6j cap plus 12k, and position vector of N is equal to 5i cap plus 4j cap minus 2k. This is the position vector of L and position vector of N. It is also L bar, it is equal to N bar. Now we have to find out the midpoint of M, position vector of M, that is we have to find out M bar, and M is a midpoint of this line LN. So what is the formula? By midpoint formula, M bar is equal to L bar plus N bar divided by 2. So M bar is equal to, the value of L bar is 7i cap minus 6j cap plus 12k cap plus value of N bar, N bar is 5i cap plus 4j cap minus 2k cap divided by 2 is equal to 7i cap and 5i cap, that is 12i cap, minus 6j cap plus 4j cap, that is minus 2j cap, 12k cap and minus 2k cap, that is plus 10k cap divided by 2. We divide 2 to its scalars, which is equal to 6i cap minus j cap plus 5k cap. This is the value of M. This is the position vector of a midpoint of M bar. By using midpoint formula, we find out the position vector of point M. This is our third example. Now our fourth example. Example number 4, if the points A 30 P, B minus 1 Q 3 and C minus 330 are collinear, then find first the ratio in which the point C divides the line segment AB and second the value of P and Q. What is the example? If the points A, B, C are collinear, then find the ratio in which the point C divides the line segment AB. We have to find out the ratio that C divides the point, the line AB, and the value of P and Q. This example is of 3 mass. 1 mass is for this, find out the position vector of C. 1 mass is for finding the value of B, and other is finding the value of Q. This is a very important example. Many of times this example can be asked for the board examination. So this is an important example. Now, how we find this example? Firstly, here given condition is that the points are collinear. If the points are collinear, then their position vectors, the coefficients of I cap, J cap, K cap are in proportion. This is we studied in note. That is, suppose A bar is equal to A1 I cap, A2 J cap, A3 K cap, and B bar is equal to B1 I cap, B2 J cap, and B3 K cap. These two, A bar and B bar, are collinear. Then we have A1 upon B1 is equal to A2 upon B2 is equal to A3 upon B3. This is the condition of collinearity, and we use this condition in this example. For that, we have to find out firstly AB bar or BC bar or AB bar or AC bar. We have to find out the two vectors. So what is that? Firstly, AB bar. AB bar is equal to what? B bar minus A bar. B bar minus A bar is equal to B bar. What is B bar? That is position vector of this point, which is equal to minus I cap plus Q J cap plus 3 K cap. Minus. What is position vector of A bar? That is 3 I cap, 0 J cap, plus P K. If we subtract these two, we have to get minus 1 and minus 3, that is minus 4 I cap. Here J cap term is absent, so plus Q J cap, and plus 3 cap minus, that is plus 3 minus P K. This is the value of A B bar. Now we find AC bar. What is AC bar? C bar minus A bar. C bar minus A bar. Then, what is the position vector of C bar? That is minus 3 I cap plus 3 J cap. Here third term is 0. Then, minus A bar. Here is A bar. That is 3 I cap plus P K cap. We subtract these two, minus 3 minus 2 get minus 6 I cap. Here 3 J cap is plus 3 J cap, and this is minus P K. This is the value of AC bar. Now ABC, 3 points are collinear. So AB bar and AC bar also collinear. AB bar and AC bar also collinear. If these two points are collinear, these two vectors are collinear, then their coefficients are in proportion. Here AB bar and AC bar are collinear. Therefore, A1 upon A2 using the note, that is minus 4 upon minus 6 is equal to Q upon 3 is equal to coefficient of K cap, that is 3 minus P upon minus P. Now, we use firstly these two inequalities, these two terms, equate these two terms. Therefore, माइनस फोर, माइनस माइनस साइन गेट कैंसिल, दैट इज फोर बाय सिक्स इज इक्वल टू क्यू बाय थ्री. हियर थ्री गेट कैंसिल टू सिक्स, दैट इज हियर रिमेन्स टू, टू गेट कैंसिल टू फोर, हियर इज टू, देयर फोर क्यू इज इक्वल टू टू. दिस इज अ वैल्यू ऑफ ए क्यू. नाउ वी यूज क्यू इज इक्वल टू इन दिस इक्वेशन, सो यूज अनदर टू इन इक्वालिटीज, दैट इज दिस टू रेशियोज. Where 2 by 3, here value of a q is 2. So 2 by 3 is equal to 3 minus 3 divided by minus 3. Get a cross multiplication, that is minus 2p is equal to multiply by 3 into 3 minus 3, that is 9 minus 3p. Here this term is negative, here we get it is positive, that is plus 3p. 3p minus 2p is equal to 9. Here 3p minus 2p is p, that is p is equal to 9. So q is equal to 2 and p is equal to 9. This is the answer for the second question, that is value of a p and q. We find out the value of a p and q. Oh. Then now we have to find out the ratio in which C divides the line AB. Now in first question, here P is equal to 9 and Q is equal to 2. Now here P is equal to 9 and Q is equal to 2. So what is the position vector? That is A bar. What is A bar? A bar is equal to 3 I cap. J cap is term neglected because there is a 0. And what is the value of P? That is 9. That is plus 9 K. Value of A bar. Now B bar. What is B bar? That is minus I cap. Here is Q. What is the value of Q? 2. That is plus 2 J cap. And plus 3 k cap. And c bar is equal to minus 3 I cap plus 3 j cap. K cap term is 0. Here a bar, b bar, c bar. Now we have to find out the ratio in which c divides ab. What is that ratio? In note we have to take, there is a ratio that is ks to 1. Whenever they ask for the ratio, we have to take the ratio k as to 1 and we have to find out the value of k. Now suppose C divides AB in the ratio k as to 1. If C divides AB in the ratio k as to 1, then by using section formula, we have C bar is equal to KB bar plus 1 A bar, that is A bar divided by K plus 1. This is our section formula. Now we put the value of here C bar, B bar and A bar. What will we get? C bar. What is the value of C bar? Minus 3 I cap plus 3 J cap is equal to K into bracket. B bar. Minus I cap plus 2 J cap plus 3 K cap. Plus A bar. What is the value of A bar? That is 3 I cap plus 9k and here divided by k plus 1. Now here k plus 1 is divided by, so multiply to this term. So k plus 1 into minus 3 I cap plus 3 j cap is equal to multiply by k, that is minus k I cap plus 2k j cap plus 3k k cap. प्लस 3i कैप प्लस 9k कैप. नाउ मल्टीप्लाई k प्लस 1 टू दिस टर्म, दैट इज माइनस 3 इंटू के प्लस 1 आई कैप, माइनस 3 इंटू के प्लस 1 आई कैप प्लस 3 इंटू के प्लस 1 जे कैप इज इक्वल टू हियर एडिशन ऑफ आई कैप एंड आई कैप, दैट इज माइनस के हियर प्लस 3 एंड गेट आई कैप कॉमन फ्रॉम दिस टू टर्म्स. आई कैप गेट कॉमन एंड हियर माइनस के एंड प्लस 3. सिमिलरली जे कैप टर्म इज सिंगल, सो राइट एज इट इज 2k जे कैप प्लस गेट कॉमन के कैप फ्रॉम दिस टू टर्म्स, वी विल गेट 3k प्लस 9k. Now this is vector here I cap j cap. This is also vector I cap j cap k cap. And there is an equal sign. Then by equality of a vector, if two vectors are equal, then their corresponding coefficients of unit vectors are also equal. So here coefficient of I cap and coefficient of I cap are equal. So therefore minus 3k plus 1 is equal to minus k plus 3. Here coefficient of I cap and I cap are equal. So solve this equation. Minus 3k plus or minus get minus 3. Minus 3k minus 3 is equal to minus k plus 3. This constant term get on RHS and the term of k get on LHS. So minus k, here is plus k, minus 3k plus k, that is minus 2k, is equal to, this minus 3 is plus 3, so is equal to 6. So k is equal to 6 upon minus 2, k is equal to minus 3. Now the ratio is k as to 1 and the value that we will get, that is minus 3. So here point C divides the AB into the ratio 3 as to 1. Then what is about sign negative? This sign indicates the division is external. If we have to get the value of K is positive, then the division is internal division. And if we get the sign of K is negative, then this is external division. So point C divides AB externally. Externally why? Because there is negative value. So externally in the ratio 3 as to 1. So this is our answer for this question. So this is the example which is of 3 mass. Very important example. Now next point is product of vectors. Product of vectors. How we get product of two vectors? Similarly, we make a multiplication of two numbers, that is 1 into 3 is 3, 2 into 3 is 6. Like that, we have to multiply two vectors. Then how we multiply that vectors? There are two types of vectors, two types of product of a vectors. What is that? One is scalar product, that is dot product, and another is vector product, which is cross product. What is dot product and how we distinguish these two? If the product results into a scalar quantity, then this is scalar product. And the product results into a vector quantity, that is vector product. Now product of a vector, in which before that we have to know the angle between two vectors. Angle between two vectors. Suppose there are two vectors, that is A bar and B bar. Two vectors, A bar and B bar. These two vectors are coincides each other, coincides, intersect each other. Then, and that angle of inclination is theta. If there is an angle is theta. So, there are two cases. If these two vectors are coincides each other, then if these two vectors are coincides each other, if their initial points are same, if their initial points are same, then the inclination is like this and this angle is theta. And if their directions are different, if the direction of this initial arc is different, that is opposite, that is opposite to this. If this direction is opposite to that initial arm, then that angle is this, that is theta. Because its direction are opposite to this, so we have to get angle theta. So this angle is acute angle and this angle is obtuse. So the value of a theta, if two vectors coincides each other, A bar and B bar, two vectors coincides each other, then we get acute angle either obtuse angle. So theta is always lies between. So theta is always lies between 0 to pi. That's why angle theta is always lies between 0 to 180 degree. Pi means 180 degree. So this is the angle between two vectors. So in this lecture we studied two examples. Out of that, second example is very important example for the examination. And product of a vector, there are two products of a vector, that is scalar product and vector product. And this concept, that is angle between two vectors, there are acute angle and obtuse angle. If initial arm in opposite condition, then there is the angle is obtuse. I hope you understand this lecture. Thank you.